One of the things that I had struggled with during my documentary filmmaking was we had to capture these specific moments that were only going to come up once, and recreating that wouldn't be possible. So when something went wrong within the camera, boy, it was a miracle to find out that Boris FX came up with something called FrameFixer ML. But now they've come up with something new, and it utilizes the same artificial intelligence model that FrameFixer used. It's called Jump Cut Fixer ML. It's a new transition for Continuum by Boris FX. So, were you keeping count? In the opening monologue, there was no way I was going to memorize that entire script for you, so I added a bunch of different cuts, and I spliced it together every time I had to pause or restart, and I used Jump Cut Fixer ML. Normally, I use a second camera to help me hide all of those cuts. But how much did I use it? 7 times. In this video, you're going to see various examples of when it works best. First of all, what is a jump cut? Well, let's take a look at normal cuts right here. There's 3 different shots, 1 close-up, 1 wide, and then 1 medium. That's a normal cut. That's a normal cut. But what if our subject said something she didn't want to say yet? For example, just out of habit, she started nodding and saying, yes, that's right. But she was thinking about her next question in the interview. So right here, she says, that's right. And so we're going to cut that out right there. Okay, so here's the that's right section. We're going to just hit delete, and we're going to delete this space. And now we have a jump cut right there. Not a whole lot has happened in this movement, so what we're going to do is drop on Jump Cut ML and make this transition morph using AI technology to create a transition from one to the other. And no more jump cut. See how it works. Go up to the effects panel, and let's go to video transitions to BCC transitions. And right down here, you'll see BCC Plus Jump Cut Fixer ML. So let's click, drag to our cut, and drop it right there. Immediately, you can see it created a blended frame. But unlike morph or a fade, it's learning what came before and after so that it can create new frames. Let's play back. Now, would you look at that? So now we timed it correctly, and the best way to use this in an interview sort of setting is to cut when there is no talking and cut again when there's no talking so that both no talking ends come together and it looks like there was no talking in between. Now, if this transition doesn't look as natural or could happen quicker, we could just shorten the length of time FrameFixer takes place. So let's shrink it by about half and play back. So in some cases, this may not look very natural, so I'm going to give you a little taste of what a more difficult shot might look like. This type of interview is an over-the-shoulder shot in a narrative, and you see right here, she interrupts. So let's change the narrative by using Jump Cut Fixer ML. Let's go to the first frame where she begins to open her mouth, and we're going to cut here, and then cut out the part where she speaks, and cut there. Delete that section, and let's make an in and out point right here. So there's our jump cut. It's pretty significant. Not only is the camera slightly wavering back and forth, but after she interrupts, she has tilted her head in a completely different direction. The biggest problem you'll notice is going to be her hair. While the transition is gradual, it does take a lot of AI frames. Like I said, our biggest issue was that her hair was hanging down on this side, and then suddenly it needed to move all the way over here. So we have duplicates of her ear stretching out here, which is totally not natural, not the look we're going for. And it also struggles with different sections of the face. In general, straight lines, like in the hair or on clothing fabric, or just anything that has a symmetrical pattern to it, will struggle. So let this be our guideline. If the movement is too significant, then we might have to justify doing a cutaway or a reverse shot. In this example, our young CEO wants to give a very professional message to all of his employees as they're about to go public. But if you know the type, you know the type. They want to look good on camera. And so when he makes a big sigh in the middle of his speech, he wants that cut out. But the camera crew was told no second camera, and we were going to do this all on the teleprompter. So how do we fix this? Let's try Jump Cut Fixer ML. So let's look for that sigh. Here it happens. You see the shoulders go up. He finishes speaking, and that's where we would want to cut. And let's go to where he's about to begin speaking again after the sigh. Here we go. Let's cut right here and get rid of that sigh. Deleted, deleted. And there's our jump cut. Before and after. Shoulders are a little higher. Chest is a little broader and the head tilts slightly. Let's apply Jump Cut Fixer ML, like so. But we want to make sure the length isn't bumping into where he's speaking. So let's shorten this by about half. I'm going to set my in and out points and hit render.
If you take a look at this now, it doesn't look at all as if he hesitated or stopped and took a big sigh. This looks like smooth talking from beginning to end right here.
You see the transition happen as the shoulders change, and you can watch his eyes, his head moving, and it is as smooth as can be. Problem solved. So let's take a look at this clip right here. This is an interview with a scientist in a lab coat, looking like he's talking about something about an old human skull, which looks kind of gross, but to each his own. Let's say that right here as he blinks and nods his head, that was a little mistake that happened. Perhaps he repeated himself unnecessarily as he emphasizes. Let's cut. I'm gonna delete that space and drag BCC Plus Jump Cut Fixer ML onto this transition. Again, let's not transition for too long and give this a shot. You can see the transition, it looks somewhat unnatural, and this is something to watch out for. As his hand turns from outward back to inward, you see a slight ripple, but it still retains the shape of his fingers. The spot that it's most significant is actually on the arm of the chair. It morphs from this side to this side. A small movement, but perhaps something worth cropping. Now let's check out this example. It was the same idea. The lighthouse blinks once, and then it double blinks, but we took out one of the blinks, so altogether it only blinks twice. In these case studies, of course I want you to see what's successful, but I also want to show you what you can avoid. For example, in this shot, the camera is moving slightly, and because the camera shifts here from one cut to another, the corrective movement happens pretty suddenly. And of course you could adjust that by lengthening your transition. When you're cutting something out, the most important part is to make sure the frames that you cut on are similar. The less movement, the less artifacts you'll experience. Now check out this shot. Let's say we didn't want this gentleman to blink his eyes. Let's take a look. Right before he begins to blink, we'll cut, and right after his eyes open enough, we're gonna cut again. Now delete that center spot and use Jump Cut Fixer ML. His eyes look great, but there's a background pattern that the AI is struggling with. Applying this transition to something simple, like a similar frame, gives a sort of muddy look to it. It kind of reminds me of a teleportation effect. And here's another good example of how you could use this for an alternative purpose. Instead of having him walk off the screen, we can make him disappear.
So that's how you'd fix a jump cut using Jump Cut Fixer ML. And you can go to borisfx.com to learn more about AI-powered plugins just like that one. My name is Zak Ciotti. Thank you for watching.